Hi, my name is Veli from Greenwood Solutions. Today we're going to be talking about DC volt drop. Specifically, I suppose, more with commercial solar systems in mind, but the same principles apply for domestic. So what exactly is DC volt drop? And why is it important? Is there a significant standard that we can reference for DC volt drop? Because the standards are extremely important. DC volt drop is a decrease in electrical potential when current flows in a circuit. It's affected by the properties of the cable under consideration. Obviously, the DC volt drop is the temperature, the ambient temperature around the cable and the cable itself. Why is it important? It's important because you want to minimize losses. Those losses in the transmission through the cable from the solar panels to the inverter have to be kept to a minimum. The energy that comes out of the solar panels is dissipated, and we want to minimize that dissipation. The energy produced from the solar panels, when it actually gets to the inverter, is less because of that transmission process. So what standard do we reference when we're talking about DC volt drop? In Australia and New Zealand, it is AS5033, and they stipulate a maximum volt drop percentage. The percentage that they allow is a maximum of 3%. For cable specs, you must reference AS3008. Let's say we have a 60 meter run from panels to the inverter, and we're using 9N panels in series. The total voltage at maximum power point of those 9N panels in series is 744 volts. And we have a 3% allowance on the volt drop. So how many volts have we actually got to play with? Well, you take that 744 volts at voltage maximum power point and you multiply that by 3%, and it comes out to around about 22 volts. We're dealing with a panel that has a short circuit of 9.51, so that's an important figure to remember. Next, we look at the cable characteristics, whether it's 4mm, 6mm or 10mm. DC volt drop cable selection. Let's say we decide to use 4mm cable. So let's have a look at the cables that we've selected, its characteristics. To do that, we need a copy or access to AS3008, and 2017 is the current publication. In this particular method, we're going to look at the millivolt per amp meter rating for the cable in question. Now, there are other methods of doing volt drop calculations on the DC and the AC side. So we've opened up AS3008 and we've looked at the appropriate table, and we've found for the 4mm cable that we've picked, it has a millivolt per amp meter drop of 10.2. We've estimated the run to be 60 meters using 19 panels in series and a voltage at maximum power point of 744 volts. And of course, the short circuit current of the panel at 9.51 amps. Millivolt per amp meter volt drop is 10.2. So how many volts have we got to play with? What allowance have we got? Well, we've got 22.32 volts, and that's 744 times 3%. I think it's very important that you actually go through the process to understand what you're doing and then check your results with one of the many online calculators that are out there for DC volt drop. So we're over at the board at the moment. We're going to go through the volt drop calculations. Look, there's a few ways of doing volt drop calculations depending on what information you've got at hand. In this case, we have 19 panels in series, so positive, negative, positive, negative, and the voltage at maximum power point is 744 volts. That's a very important figure, and that's what we'll use in the calculation. Now, we're allowed, as mentioned, 3% maximum. So what we do is we take the voltage at maximum power point, we multiply that at 3%, and here's the magic figure, 22.32 volts. That's what we've got to play with. Look, from a prudent approach in regards to commercial design, you want to be way under that in your calculations, but this is what the max suggests, 3%. The panel we're using has a short circuit current of 9.51 amps, and we've selected 4mm cable, and then we go to the Australian standard, as I mentioned previously, AS3008. I won't tell you what table, you'll have to have a look. and we look at the rating of this cable, the millivolt per amp meter. So that means for every 1 amp we put through the cable for 1 meter, what is the drop, the loss going to be in millivolts? At 90 degrees, and for this particular 4 mm cable, it is 10.2, so that's a very important figure. Then we go to the calculation, and as I said before, this is just one of many calculations. You can look at resistivity of copper and do another calculation. There's a few ways of doing this, and as I said before, please check your results with some of the online calculators, and they can really vary. So, the volt drop or rise. Now remember, volt drop and rise are the same mathematically. It just depends on what you're trying to ascertain. We've got a 60 meter run. We've got the panel, and it's a single string, so we haven't paralleled it. 9.51 amps, 60 meter run. 10.2 is our millivolt per amp meter volt drop factor. We take that over 1,000, as you can see, and there we go. We've got 5.8 volts of volt drop, and that is 0.75%, so that's way under. Thanks very much for watching our presentation on volt drop calculations on the DC side. A very important area, and an area a lot of installers don't really look at very closely. We appreciate all suggestions, all questions and answers, and please subscribe. Thanks very much.